Hi, today I'm going to be looking at keyboard shortcuts. Now I realise there's quite a lot that you could use, but the ones I've selected are what I feel are the more useful and more productive ones to have. So let's get to it. The first one I put down is Alt and Tab, which is a Windows switch. So I'll just demonstrate that now, Alt and Tab. Now, as you can see, I've got four tasks open there. There's Firefox, Calculator, OpenOffice Documents, and Mahjong. So I can choose which one I want by just selecting as I go through them. Okay. The next one is the Super Key and Tab, which is the flip switcher. Now, the Super Key is also known as the Windows Key. So I'll just demonstrate that now. Super and Tab. So again, I'm browsing through the various documents and programs I got open. So let's just say I want the calculator, just release it. If you want to go back to the or any of the other programs that are running, I'll just press the Super key and Tab again. Say Firefox, and do it again. To the office, OpenOffice document. Now the next one is the Super key and scroll wheel, and all it does is just zooms into the screen really. I'll just demonstrate that now. So you press the Super key and move your scroll wheel. Just move the mouse whichever way you want really. And the next one is the CTRL ALT and D, which shows the desktop. Now this has a toggle function. So you press it once, it will show the desktop. Press it again, it'll put things back to where they were before. So I'll just demonstrate that now. CTRL ALT and D. And again, CTRL ALT delete to go back to where we were. The next one is the Super key and E, which shows all the workspaces. Now I've only got two workspaces set, so let's just go there now, Super and E, and as you can see, there they are. Again, this has a toggle function, so you press it again and it'll go back to what you were doing before. Next one is Control and A, basically that selects everything. Just demonstrate it, Control and A. Yeah. Now the next one is Alt and F10. It maximises the current window, and as you can see, this OpenOffice document is the current window, so I'm just going to minimise that slightly. So as it says, Alt and F10 maximises the current window. So this is the current window, and you press Alt and 10, I'll just do that now. There we are. And if you want to minimise that completely, you just press Alt and F9. Just demonstrate that. Let's go back to it. And the next one is very useful. It's Control Alt and L, which locks the screen. What that does, it just shuts everything down in terms that it puts the screensaver on. And what you have to do then, if you want to unlock the screen, you've got to put in your password. So I'll just demonstrate that now. Control Alt and L. Control Alt and L. Now you can see the screensaver's kicked in. So all I've got to do now is move the mouse, and it's asking me to for the password to unlock. And I'll just do that now. And then click unlock. There we are. Very useful. Alt and F2 opens the run application. So Alt and F2. Then the final one is Control and Alt, and if you move the left and right arrow key, that moves between the workspaces. So I'll just demonstrate that now. Control, Alt, and left or right. That's left, right. All it is really is just moving between, as I say, the workspaces. You can do it this way as well, the bottom. Okay, so I hope some of these will be useful to you anyway. As I say, there's a lot more that you can use, but I find these personally are more useful. Okay, thanks for watching.